Hey guys, Carter here with Patriot Training Center, and today I'm out here on the range and I'm gonna do a quick little practice session. So been dry firing a lot. Actually just got back from a class, so I live fired quite a bit. I'm 100% cold today, but I'm gonna run through a little training session. I'm filming this for you guys, just for you guys to watch when you're at home, you're wondering what to do when you're about to have a range day. So the biggest thing is we want to maximize the amount of skills that you're building for the amount of work you're putting in and ammo. So if you only have a limited amount of ammo, you want to make sure you're doing as much of that as you possibly can. So make sure that you're thinking about your training. You're not just going in and running through boxes of ammo with no goal in mind. So today I'm going to run through Tom Givens' baseline assessment. It's a super short course of fire, and I'm just going to see where I'm at and then go from there and see what I need to work on. So let's get started. All right, we're gonna speed this up for you guys so you don't have to watch me shooting the whole time, but we'll put the courses that I'm shooting down below so you guys can follow along if you want and try it out. So I'm gonna go ahead and start shooting, and you guys will see parts of it, but yeah, go check that description below for those if you wanna shoot them live.
Minutes later.
Okay, so I just shot the baseline assessment. What I like about that is I'm working a bunch of different skills. It's only 20 rounds and it's kind of assessing where I'm at. I'm working, everything's from the ready, so I'm not really getting the holster benefit of drawing from the holster and shooting. But as far as marksmanship under speed goes, I like this drill for that. My draw to first shot's pretty quick, so I'm not really working on that today. I want to evaluate the different skills that I'm going to be using, which is, can I reload and get my hits? Can I shoot fast enough to get really accurate hits, but not too fast that I start going all over the paper? And then can I shoot my dominant and non-dominant hand? And the answer was no, I can't shoot my non-dominant hand. So what am I going to work on? The non-dominant hand. I've only shot 20 rounds out of a box of ammo, so I'm gonna take the rest of the ammo in the box of 50 and work on my non-dominant hand until I get it right. So I'm gonna start back here at 5 yards, and I'm gonna run it and see if I can, a lot of it is about feel. So I'm gonna go back to the basics. Is my side alignment good? All of that. What I really think it is, I think I'm just pushing it or I'm letting it go down. So I'm gonna work on just working that trigger finger straight to the rear and letting the gun break. So I'm gonna test it out. So I'm gonna shoot these magazines. I'm gonna try and put as many as I can in the 10 ring. So I'll shoot 5 and see where I'm at. See?
Now I'm right in the middle of the 10 ring. That one is not. That one is not, also. Alright, let's go take a look.
So I put one in the 10, or 3 in the 10 ring, and then 2 low. And as you can see, I have a really nasty dip on that non-dominant arm. So I'm going to work on that, see if I can isolate that, and keep going. And if you need to, you could change up your grip pressures, whatever. I don't think mine's grip pressure. I think I'm just not used to shooting with my non-dominant hand as much as I should be. Okay, so that one was a little bit better. It's definitely just a motion that I'm doing when the gun's going off. I put another one right there, but most of them were actually in this X-ring. So that's good. I'm gonna keep working on it and see if I can really isolate that and keep doing what I'm really doing is I'm watching my I'm watching what my sight is doing and trying to replicate how all the hand tension and arm tension is feeling when I'm pressing the shot off, and I can usually see when it's a really bad shot before I actually see the target. So I'm really just trying to call my shots and see, like, oh, was that a good trigger press? What was I doing on that? And then try and do more of the thing that is getting the result that I want. See, I got 5 or 6 more in here. See if I can put some in the ten ring here. All right. I think all those were in, what? Pretty close. All right. So it's getting better. Now I just need to be able to do that a little bit faster. I've slowed it down, trying to see what I'm doing. Let's see if I can speed it up a little bit and get under some time pressure and see if I can nix those bad shots. All right. I think there's an extra in here. So this one was for sure not there in this one. So still not quite there yet. I'm going to keep working on it. Keep in mind too, what I would be doing also after this is I'd be working dry fire with my non-dominant hand and trying to get all those grip pressures and things down because I can only do so much out here. What I'm doing here is verifying the skills that I've been working on. So I come out here and assess where I'm at, and then I see the weaknesses in those assessments, and then I'm going to dry fire those. And I'm going to work on them at the range, but I'm also going to be dry firing them. So next time I come out, theoretically, those weaknesses should be better. I've got some really bad flyers. This one, I didn't let my dot settle. I was trying to, I just didn't let my dot settle. So everything is, it's tightening up a little bit. But like I said before, there's only so much that you're going to be able to do just sitting here doing it. I would take the rest of the ammo from that box, and I'm going to keep working on that with that box. And then if it's not really getting much better, or you're seeing a little bit of improvement, but you're going to get tired and start making mistakes, go ahead and just realize that you're going to have to work on that in dry fire and work on getting that sight, or getting the sight the way you want to get those grip pressures and work that trigger straight to the rear without disturbing the sights, and doing that in dry fire, getting that neuro pathways built in dry fire, so when you come out here it gets better. So I'm going to keep going on some other stuff. Okay guys, so after I shoot the B8s and I've kind of seen some of my marksmanship issues and what I need to work on in dry fire, I'm going to go the next 50 rounds and I'm going to do something a little bit more practical. So I'm going to shoot our Patriot Training Center target right here, and I'm going to do most of my work from 3 to 7 yards coming from the holster, maybe some reload stages, and then I'm going to go back to 15 and 20 yards. I'm going to do a lot less of that because it's less probable in a self-defense situation, but you don't want to neglect those skills because you do have some outliers in there where that actually does happen. So you don't want to neglect the skills of 15 and 25 yards, but we're going to do the bulk of our work here at 3 to 7. And so I'm going to do some training there and see where we're at. Still back. Okay, guys, so I just shot that little course of fire there. That's working on a lot of different skills. We're working back at all those distances. I had some reloads in there. I did some precision headshots. And then obviously I did the last eight rounds back at 15 and 25 yards. And those were all in the chest. So I didn't pull anything out of the chest on those. And then I had two headshots. One of those just went just ever so slightly high. One was pretty far down in the mouth, but for 50 rounds, not too bad. I wasn't super slow on any of my times, so that's a good little training session on that. It was only 100 rounds. I worked a lot of different skills, and I kind of saw where I'm at. If you guys want to get better at shooting, there's a link in the description below. It's a 30-day dry fire program. It's going to help you on all your skills that you need to know when you're shooting your gun. We'll catch you guys in the next one.